second goal a minute from half-time. Jim Beglin giving the ball straight to Lewis. Penny's unmarked on the touchline. Gordon Strachan's header put his own defence in trouble. They appealed for handball. It came off Steen's chest and Simpson applies the perfect finish. Leeds 2-0 down at half-time and the obituaries for their promotion challenge already being written. They were premature. Just before the hour, Stirling sets up Chapman with all the time he needed. And look at the determination on the Leeds faces. The fans may have sensed something special was in the air, and it was. Glenn Snowden was another Leeds man starting his first game of the season. His cross. Substitute Henry plays it back in, and Varadi does what Howard Wilkinson bought him to do. Vinnie Jones is always on hand for the celebration. 2 minutes later, it was Jones' throw that caused turmoil, and Chris Fairclough find its first, second, third time lucky. Leeds 3-2 in front at 20-5, but there were still 15 minutes left because of yet another late kickoff. Time enough for Gary Speed to catch Foster in possession. He keeps his head well here, and Chapman keeps scoring. Now, Vinnie here is late for the celebrations. He arrives with a quiet word of congratulation for Chapman, a firm message for Alexi Sale, and a cuddle for the referee. Leeds were enjoying themselves at the end of 45 minutes, which could prove the turning point in the title race. Foster clashes with Hendry in the last minute, and the referee gives a penalty. Now, Gordon Strachan, the penalty king at Elland Road, delegated Chapman to take it to try for his hat-trick. The Leeds bench tried to stop this, knowing goal difference could be vital. And as it turned out, they had a point. But Leeds had three. Oxford 2, Leeds 4.